Hi and welcome to the Gadget Show Web TV. Now for this week's first look, John's managed to get his hands on the latest 3D smartphone. It's the HTC Evo.
In today's 3D with everything world, it's not surprising we're starting to see a few 3D phones, and this is HTC's first, the new HTC Evo 3D. You can immediately tell it's a 3D phone because it hasn't just got one camera lens on the back, it's got two. The LED flash there is nestling between them. If you use it in 2D mode, selecting that with the switch here on the side, you'd use just one of the lenses, which takes stills up to 5 megapixels in resolution. Flick the switch over to 3D, both lenses come into operation and you can shoot 3D stills of up to 2 megapixels and shoot 720p video. To compose your shots, when you're in 3D, the screen of the phone switches to a 3D glasses-free display. It's not the best example of its kind I've seen. It can be quite difficult to get into the right position to get a realistic 3D image. You can also use this screen to play back your shots and videos, but again, I don't think it's necessarily the best. You're probably better off hooking the phone up to your 3D TV via HDMI. In fact, overall, whether in 2D or 3D, I don't think the camera is that brilliant. The colours aren't that great. You tend to get quite a bit of compression artifacting in the images. Certainly Nokia N8 or indeed Samsung's Galaxy S2 gives better 2D images. Of course, it's not just about shooting 3D video and stills. Having said that though, there are no 3D animations or menus on the phone, although there will be 3D games and hopefully some 3D movies as well. Of course, throughout all that, you're still at the mercy of this rather lackluster 3D screen. Overall, it hasn't made me excited about the prospect of having 3D on a phone, which is a pity because as a 2D phone, this is one of the best HTCs I've tried. It is a bit heavy, 170 grams, but the battery life is pretty impressive for an HTC. The call quality is good, the reception's very good as well, and the screen, although the colours are a bit muted in 2D, nevertheless, it has a very high resolution. It's a very fast phone with its 1.2 gigahertz processor, plenty of RAM. Overall, very satisfying as a phone. I just wish that instead of lavishing all this effort on the 3D, then instead fitted it with a really top-class 2D camera. Then it would really be a winner.